gently thank you all for continuing your commitment to this channel, to our Instagram account and our website, and also to all those who have bought their book. Today, we are going on a field trip to a very special place to me called the Ecology Center. It's actually where Andrew and I got married, and it is in Orange County in a town called San Juan Capistrano, and it is a farm. It is a living, breathing, regenerative, organic, working farm that sell their produce out of their incredible farm stand, and they also do incredible events around education, around our food system, around growing your own food, about how to save seeds, to dyeing clothing with natural dyes, to amazing dinner series they do. So a plethora of many, many things they do, some of which we'll see today because we're going to their taste festival. And the theme is strawberries. So I hope you can just be imagining the strawberries that we're going to see, eat, and taste. Another great thing that the Ecology Center do is they connect with those neighbors in need around them, which is donating a percent, I think it's about 20% of their food to neighbors in need. And also a new program they're doing, which is actually cooking meals, I think once a month or weekly, that they donate to their neighbors in need. So there is a feature of the Ecology Center in Go Gently, and here there's some lovely photographs and a little bit about the explanation of the Ecology Center, and also some great actionable steps that you could take to do and maybe connect with something similar to this. Maybe it's a community garden in your local area, maybe it's a small urban farm, or maybe you're in a rural area and you can actually connect with larger scale farms, and just many different ways that we can shorten our supply chain by buying local foods in season is an incredible action, positive action that you can take against our climate crisis, and just really resist against these large-scale food systems that create a whole plethora of issues within our world. But anyway, let's turn our gaze to a lovely, positive, wonderful space called the Ecology Center. We're going to go meet Evan Marks, who is the founder of the Ecology Center, who I first met through my friend Tom Cattelier, who is part of Designers on Holiday, which is the design group that designed and created a lot of the communal spaces at the Ecology Center. So that's how I came to meet them. Right, we better pack our bags and head over to San Juan Capistrano.
Does Billy get to come?
Maybe. He's a good boy.
What kind of treats are we gonna find at the farm?
I don't know. Should we go check it out?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's go.
Lovely to be back here again, Evan, at the Ecology Center. I'd love to hear the evolution of this space and where we are, and yeah, your intention behind this land and interacting with this town and community.
You know, this is a very special house and a special place. This is a 140-year-old farmhouse. When I started in 2008, it was an empty house in a dirt lot. Remnants of the health and the breath of this place is on this farm. The conversations that happen here are very proactive towards purpose. The hundreds of families that come through here every day, and just the turning on, mm-hmm. inspiration, and really that transforms beyond just the feeling, but it really hopeful into action. We've got a strawberry festival today.
What's your favorite thing, Seiji? Strawberries?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Should we go check the strawberries out?
You want that one? You eat it.
Can I have my own chocolate?
Yay!
apples.
Oh my god.
Yeah, the darker the better. This is one of my favorites, little gems, kind of a baby romaine. Do you want to try it? You like lettuce. We call this one French breakfast. You see the white on this one?
Yeah.
It's cool, right? These will get harvested this week, and then we'll start over. It's a puzzle piece.
Probably picked about 400 heads of lettuce. I don't know, maybe a couple, like a few pounds each box, maybe? Yeah, tons, lots of lettuce.
What is the choice and reason behind growing such a diverse collection of plants and flowers, and what does that do for each other?
Building the ecology, the economy, and then creating the equity within our food system. The diversity does all three of those. It all adds up to a healthier puzzle. From the economy standpoint, we sell all of our food and flowers direct to our community, and that's out the farm stand and through our farm share. We donate 20% of what we grow to our neighbors in need. We're in this together, you know, and especially we're focusing on a couple of core communities, one around our farm here and our other farm in Encinitas. And then those families participate in our cooking classes, they participate in our spring festivals, and they're just part of the community. You guys, we're gonna take our friends on a tour of the farm stand. Will you come with me?
I will come with you.
I feel like too, during the pandemic, so many people, including myself, would then now more newly rely and engage with programs like that, because I think we're being so much more aware of our food supply chain, suddenly not having the availability of things that we were always used to being able to see on the shelves of a grocery store. Definitely the chain reaction of it not being there, I think, taught a lot of people about accessibility. It's not always available all the time. We're used to getting any type of food at any time of the year, and like losing that relationship to the idea that only kind of having the food that's locally grown to you and therefore in season.
Building something more meaningful than just taking, taking, taking. That's ultimately the food system model that's being presented at the grocery store. You may come from a place that's probably a little bit more connected to some of these greater community ethos, which is the butcher, the baker, and the candlestick maker. You can't ever lose value to working with our hands and learning skills and then contributing towards our community needs and values.
The minute you can see the person behind who grew it or raised it, I think you completely take a newfound respect.
We're eating blackberries and strawberries. It's late spring, and pretty soon we're going to be eating tomatoes, and we're going to be so excited about that. And we haven't had tomatoes for 6 months, so that makes it even that much more special.
This is the new Grow Your Own nursery shop. Tom built this with designers on holiday. People can come to the farm, they can be inspired, and then they can go home and start their own garden with the resources you offer here.
Care for the planet, care for people, and share our surplus, and how that ultimately slices into the farm is we want to build an ecological model that has economy to sustain itself and equity in order to nourish the community around us. We're finding the balance of those pieces. You know, COVID really pushed us into the equity and the economy, and now we get to come back to getting back into the natural pattern of the moon and the sun. And
you must, I'm sure, witness people like maybe seeing things for the first time or interacting with things for the first time.
We did it perfectly wrong, right? Starting however many generations ago, we designed a species that was completely at odds with their environment. Sort of like the reintroduction to the earth is what sustains us, and it's joyful and delicious. Mm-hmm. I see a lot of people just really starting to peel back those layers of false realization and show up with a new awakening in their lives.
What hat are you wearing? So cute. Where'd you get that?